डिजिटल कम्युनिकेशन मॉड्यूल 4 द रिवीजन पार्ट। द मॉड्यूल 4 इज कम्युनिकेशन थ्रू बैंड लिमिटेड चैनल्स। वी नो दैट द चैनल बैंडविड्थ अवेलेबल इज लिमिटेड, सो नाउ हाउ टू अचीव एफिशिएंट ट्रांसमिशन थ्रू दिस and what are all the techniques available to achieve efficient transmission in the available bandwidth. So that mainly covers this particular module. The first topic included in this module is the digital transmission through band limited channels. So here the digital PAM transmission, that is pulse amplitude modulation transmission through band limited channels. So that is the first topic. And the second topic is signal design for band limited channels. It includes design of band limited signals for zero ISI, that is a zero inter symbol interference. So that does nothing but the Nyquist criteria. So here mainly we'll be discussing about the statement only statement of the Nyquist criteria, not the derivation part. Then design of band limited signals with the controlled ISI, that is partial response signals. Since achieving zero ISI is possible only in theory, but in practical it is not possible, so we go for controlled ISI, that is partial response signals. So that part we'll be studying here. The next topic is probability of error for detection of digital PAM, digital pulse amplitude modulated signal. So in that, the probability of error for detection of digital PAM with zero ISI, zero inter symbol interference, then symbol by symbol detection of data with controlled ISI. So these two parts again now we'll be discussing here in this topic. And the next important topic is channel equalization. Actually, in communication system, mainly in the receiver, equalizers are used to remove the or to nullify the effect of noise. So here mainly we'll be studying about two types of equalizers, that is linear equalizers and adaptive equalizers. In linear equalizers, again we have two types, or we'll be discussing about two types of equalizers, that is ZFE, that is zero forcing equalizer, and the second one is MMSE, that is minimum mean square error linear equalizer. So these two types of equalizers we study in linear equalizers. Let us start the revision by considering some old question papers, old university question papers. The first question paper what I am considering here is June-July 2018. So in that, the first question, if you see, with a neat block diagram of a digital PAM system, obtain the expression for inter-symbol interference, ISI. Here what we need to do is, initially we should draw the block diagram of a digital pulse amplitude modulation system, and again derive the expression for the inter-symbol interference for the same. So here the split up will be something like 3 plus 3. Is equal to 6. The next question is state and prove Nyquist criterion for zero ISI. But the thing is, in the syllabus it is clearly mentioned like Nyquist criteria statement only is included, derivation is not included. So here in this case what we can do is just write the statement of a Nyquist criteria for zero inter-symbol interference. The next question is, yeah, it is a problem. The problem statement is, for the binary data sequence DN given by 11101001, determine the pre-coded sequence, transmitted sequence, received sequence, and the decoded sequence. So these four sequences we have to calculate. If you see the solution part of this, the pre-coded sequence can be obtained by the equation PM is equal to DM modulo 2 subtraction with PM minus 1, and the transmitted sequence is obtained by the equation 2 pm minus 1 plus 2 p minus 1 minus 1. Similarly, use the received sequence and decoded sequence equations to write the sequences. The next question is, explain the design of band limited signals with the controlled ISI. So this question is very important. The procedure and the set of equations to design the band limited signals with controlled ISI, that should be included. The next question is, what is a zero forcing equalizer? With a neat block diagram, explain the operation of linear transversal filter. Here we should explain what is zero forcing equalizer, that is ZFE. It is for 3 marks, and with a neat block diagram, explain the operation of linear transversal filter. The block diagram for linear transversal filter should be drawn, and its operation should be explained. So this is again for 3 marks. The next question paper considered is December 2018, January 2019. The first question here is, with a neat block diagram, explain the digital PAM, pulse amplitude modulation, modulated transmission through band limited baseband channels. Also obtain the expression for inter-symbol interference. So again, the repeated question. First part is, with the block diagram, explain the digital PAM transmission system, that is for 5 marks, and also obtain the expression for inter-symbol interference. Sorry, the first part is for 3 marks, and obtain the expression for inter-symbol interference again for 3 marks. The next question is, explain the modified duobinary signaling scheme with the pre-coding. Then illustrate the encoding for the binary sequence 0111 00101. Assume previous pre-coder output as 1. Here the first part is, explain the modified duobinary signaling scheme that with the pre-coding. This concept should be explained for 3 marks. Then illustrate the encoding for the binary scheme given here, assuming previous pre-coder output as 1. So this problem is also solved in the class video. This can be considered for 4 marks, so totally 7. The next question is, with a neat diagram, explain the timing features pertaining to the I diagram and its interpretation for baseband binary data transmission system. The timing features for I diagram is very important. We should draw the I diagram, and we should explain its features for 3 marks. The next question is, with a neat sketches and expressions, explain raised cosine spectrum solution to reduce ISI. One method to reduce inter-symbol interference. With the diagram and expressions, we should explain raised cosine spectrum. It is for 6 marks. Then what is the advantage of controlled ISI partial response signaling scheme? With the block diagram, explain the duobinary encoder with the pre-coder. Mention the frequency response, impulse response, and its features. Here, the advantage of controlled ISI, inter-symbol interference partial response signaling scheme, should be mentioned around 3 to 4 points we can mention here. Then with the block diagram, explain the duobinary encoder scheme with the pre-coder. So that should be explained, and the frequency response and impulse response and its features, that again should be explained. So mainly for 6 marks. Then the last question is, with the neat diagram and the relevant expressions, explain the concept of adaptive equalization. Since the question is asked only for 4 marks, so we can write any one this one, what adaptive equalization method. For example, linear adaptive equalizer based on MSE criterion, or an adaptive zero forcing equalizer, any one concept can be explained with diagram and expressions. The next question paper is December 2019, January 2020. So here the first question is, what is ISI, that is inter-symbol interference? Then obtain the expression of output of a filter with the inter-symbol interference. So this question is asked for 8 marks. So what is ISI? We should explain what is inter-symbol interference, mainly for 2 marks, it carries 2 marks with here. Then obtain the expression for output of a filter with inter-symbol interference. This should be explained clearly with the relevant expressions, mainly for 6 marks. Then the next question is, explain the Nyquist criteria for distortionless baseband binary transmission and obtain the ideal solution for 0 ISI inter-symbol interference. This question is asked for 8 marks. So the first part, explain the Nyquist criteria for distortionless baseband binary transmission. So the split up we can give in this way for 4 marks, and obtain the ideal solution for 0 ISI again for 4 marks. Then the next question is, draw and explain the time domain and frequency domain of duobinary and the modified duobinary signals. Yeah, we have already studied about duobinary and modified duobinary signals. We should draw and explain the time domain and frequency domain duobinary and modified duobinary signals for 8 marks. Then the last question is, what is channel equalization? With a neat diagram, explain the concept of equalization using linear transversal filter. Here it is clearly asked, and it is for 8 marks. Here in the first part, we should explain what is channel equalization. We should explain what exactly it is and why it is required. It is for 2 marks. Then the second part is, with a neat diagram, explain the concept of equalization using a linear transversal filter. Here we should draw the block diagram for linear transversal filter and the concept of equalization using linear transversal filter should be explained with the relevant equations. The allotted marks for this part is 6. So we can split up this one something like for block diagram 3 marks, and for the relevant expressions and explanations, 3 marks, totally 6.